Hey everyone, this is Nikki with Dr. Patel's office. Today we're gonna go over a step-by-step tutorial on how to take photos from home for a virtual consultation or a virtual follow-up. Whether you're a patient of Dr. Patel's or just a patient of a plastic surgeon, it is really important to take good quality photos for a virtual consultation so your doctor can do morphs. High quality photos are really important. And for a virtual follow-up, just to see how your progress is doing. We wanted to make this video for you so you kind of have an idea on how to take really good photos. Step one, you're gonna wanna find a blank canvas. Ideally a wall, but if you don't have a blank wall, one thing people don't really think about are doors. So a door is always a good option. If you have something on your door, take it off. And then you have your blank canvas. So we got our blank canvas. Ideally, if you have a friend or somebody to help you take your photos, that's ideal. Make sure they get all of your photos at eye level. And I know girls just like me right now, we have our baby hair, so we want it to look cute, but we're gonna need these with our hair back so we can get a full view of your face. You're gonna wanna stand, the first position is you're gonna want a straight on position. Shoulders back, nice and tall, and look at eye level. And no smiling, keep your face relaxed because it's very important for your doctor to have a relaxed photo. Secondly, you're gonna wanna do your quarter turn. Quarter turn, you're gonna turn slightly diagonal, like this. And for your friend, whoever is helping you, you're gonna wanna see a little bit more of their other eye and maybe of their upper cheek. That's when you know it's a true quarter turn. Lastly, you're gonna want to do your side profile. We get many pictures like this. We want it perpendicular. Make sure it's at eye level as well. Not too up, not too down, just at eye level. If you don't have a friend to help you with your photos, do not worry. You can do them yourself, and here are the steps. All right, so you're gonna wanna go to your camera, hit timer, and once you hit timer, you're gonna have an option for a countdown. Once you select a countdown, you'll see numbers appear on the screen. And once you see the numbers, put your phone on the shelf, and there you go.